Good afternoon. It's actually 20 past one. Spent most of the morning in town with Mum. Something's itching on my arse, another one of them fucking bike things. Tilting the camera. Don't know if it's gonna come up on camera or not. Hang on. I've got to find it. No, it's not. At least I can't see it on my screen. Oh, there it is. I keep getting those popping up everywhere on me and they itch like fudge. Anyway. Someone is looking to possibly part exchange a bike for my blue suspension bike, which I'm happy to do. The bike he wants to part exchange, going by the photo, it looks like it's only suitable for parts, but if I get a bit of cash, you know, I've got cash and a bike for parts anyway, so I'm not fussed. Preferred full cash, but never mind. I'm flexible. He wants to come tomorrow afternoon to have a look, so he's got till then. Between you and me, this person has never been very reliable anyway. Right. It's driving me up the wall. My plan for this afternoon is to actually go downstairs. I need to have a look for some wheels anyway, so considering I've got to empty the shed to get to the wheels, figured I'm going to take my step ladders down and just have a sort out in there. I might take a rubbish bag down with me and see if I can have a big old clean out down there, because it's full of shit, basically. In fact, someone's put a little kitchen bin down by the bins out there anyway, you know. A creamy beige version of my grey bins over there, so I may, it looks in good condition, so I may grab that and just chuck all my rubbish in there. So it looks like someone's moved out of one of the flats at the other end of the block. There was a big old van that had been hired up there and they were loading furniture into it, so another vacant flat up the other end. No one seems to stay in that particular flat very long. A friend of mine used to live there and he'd lived there well over 10 years before he moved out. And ever since then, it just hasn't been occupied for very long. He moved out about a year ago. Something like that now. And in that time, it hasn't been occupied for very long before someone moves out. Actually, I think this person was there longer than the last tenant anyway. So, I'm going to get my butt into gear while the weather's nice, because Mum said it's supposed to rain later, according to the weather forecast, so. I do like that with that Dell charger. It goes off as soon as I take the phone off, though. And take that off, you see? It goes off. It works. Ish. I was going to say it's charging, but that light will go off. Right. Are you sleeping up there, are you? He was sleeping on the bathroom towel in the bath. Most of the day yesterday. I've got to remember I need to bring this back up as well. I've got things to put in my cupboard. I might. Might take the camera down with me, I don't know. Well, there's anything I've shown the shed and there isn't really anything in there of interest. Just bikes, basically. Bikes and bikes and bikes. Actually, I've got to service one of them that's down there. I might need to take a valve adapter down with me. I don't think I've got one that'll fit down there. Oh! Yes, I have. It's on the racer bike. Okay, so I don't have to bother with that. Do I need my foot pump down there? Not at the moment. I'm not going to change the wheel in that rally just yet. I'll go sort the shed first. It's quite busy out here. Then again, it is a Thursday. It's busy in town as well. Mum didn't go to work today because she had a dental appointment. She had that tooth out last week, and they believe she's got what's called a dry socket, which means the hole where the tooth was looks like it may be infected, and it's where the scab should have been, you know, where it bleeds and scabs over, has just, it's gone, it's dissolved for some reason, so she's very, very sore where that tooth was. She's been in pretty much constant pain since she had the tooth out. And it's very, very sensitive to hot and cold foods. So at the moment, the dentist is treating for what they call a dry socket, giving her antibiotics and an antiseptic mouthwash. My mum actually said, after that, it does actually feel better, because the dentist gave her a mouthwash while she was in there. Her breath smelled like aniseed. So it must have been sort of like an aniseed-y flavour mouthwash. And Mum did say it did feel better after that, so hopefully it's that. If the treatment for dry socket doesn't work, then she's going to have one, maybe the two teeth that sit either side of the hole out as well, because it could be causing the problem. Which, I know Mum is due to have three teeth out altogether. She's had one. I know the dentist wants to take out further two, but I can't remember which two. But hopefully, you know, for Mum, that this treatment will work. I hope. Because when I was growing up as a kid, I had a lot of dental work done. I actually had braces, removable brace up the top, and I was supposed to keep it in even when I ate, but I used to take it out because it pissed me off. Fucking annoying trying to eat with that in your mouth, and you get all your food stuck behind the plate anyway. So you'd end up having to take it out after you've eaten to, you know, brush your teeth and clean it out. So I just figured it'd be easier just to take it out, eat, brush my teeth, put it back in. Which is what I used to do. But most of my baby teeth were actually taken out either by the dentist. One was actually taken out accidentally by my dad. You're probably wondering, how the hell can someone take out a tooth accidentally? Well, because I was only little, Dad was... It was after I had a bath, and Dad, you know, was drying my hair with a towel, and the towel was getting a bit raggedy, you know, it had some strands of thread on it, and somehow the strand of thread just got wrapped around my tooth, and the next thing I know, Dad had yanked on the towel, and his tooth had just gone doing and gone with it. So, yeah, it wasn't deliberate, it was an accident. That did scare him crap, because I was a bit of blood, you know. But I can actually honestly remember only one of my baby teeth falling out naturally. May have been more, but I can only remember one. And I think I was eating a sandwich at the time, if memory serves correct. I didn't bite into the sandwich. I actually knocked the tooth with the sandwich, and it fell out eventually. But yeah. All the front ones removed by dentist. Bottom ones were removed by dentist. The front top ones either fell out naturally, or that was one of the ones that got hooked up round the thread from the bath towel. Yeah, most of my back ones I had pulled out as well. Yeah, lots of needles. So, yeah, local anaesthetic is not one of my favourite things. But I actually have to say, when I had that ingrown toenail removed when I was 13, that was the worst anaesthetic needle I'd ever felt. That actually brought tears to my eyes. That stung that much. Oh, that hurt. But it was so good to have that ingrown toenail dealt with, so it was worth it. Although my foot didn't half throb like fuck when that anaesthetic wore off. After about 12 hours, I think I took to wear off. I know it took a long while. What ticked me off as well, I couldn't go upstairs to go to bed. I had to sleep on the lounge because I had to sit with my foot elevated for 48 hours. Which, when you're a kid, and all you want to do is go and play and do things, you know, it's a bit of an annoyance. It probably wouldn't bother me so much these days. Anyway, less story time. I'm going to go downstairs and get some shit did. I could probably think of lots of stories to tell you from my childhood. I can remember all sorts from my childhood, but I can't remember what I did yesterday. How does that work? Talk to you later. I've been a busy bee this afternoon. I've sorted the shed out. I've got a bit, well, I wouldn't say a bit more room down there, but it's a bit more organised. I had all my bike wheels out, as well as the bikes, including what was up on the shelf. On the top shelf, all that's up there wheel-wise now is two pairs of racing bike wheels. Actually, I think a pair would be better off in a hybrid cycle. And some 20-inch wheels, which I keep spare for my trailer. And tyres. And I've got one 20-inch wheel up there, which is spare for a shopper bike. Then I threw a bunch of mud guards up there and some handlebars right at the front of the shelf, so they're easy to get to. The mountain bike wheels I found, I think there's about eight of them. I've brought all of them upstairs and stacked them in the cupboard up here. I've got three more in this lounge to go in there. Four, actually, because there's one in the hallway. I've had the tube out of that BMX wheel. That's that tube there. I've pulled a thorn out of this tyre. I'm going to check it for some more. But I've got three inner tubes up there, which I'm waiting on, just to see if they go flat. And I've got black rims in this one. Now, I've opted for black rims because A, they don't actually look too bad in that frame. B, it's the only wheel I've got that can support an 8-speed cassette, because that's what was on that wheel. And see, I found a matching front wheel anyway. Well, it's not an identical match, but it's close enough. Thought that front wheel might have been off to one side. I don't think it is. I think it's just the way I'm sitting here. So, yeah, that's done. The Apollo mountain bike, I've sold. Got the grand total of £10 for it. But I also got a bike for it as well. And no, it's not the same person that offered me that crap heap of a bike this morning. Look at this. I'll see if I can show you, if I can just bring up the message. This is what he was offering as an exchange. I don't know how well it's coming up, but I'm not sure if that's paint or bird shit all over it. The chain, well, you can see it's rusted beyond use. Not quite sure. I'm what to make of it. And he's offering that as part X. But this person, they asked for a bike, I don't know, about a week ago. And, he came up and he made me an offer, a ladies' mountain bike, which was his girlfriend's, whose dad had just bought her a brand new one. And which there was nothing, there's nothing wrong with it apart from there's an issue with the gears where the gears slip apparently, so. But I did check it over and I can't see nothing else wrong with it, to be honest. It's not too bad, it's pretty clean. It's actually one that I sold his girlfriend's mum quite a while back. And she sold it to her daughter and now I've got it back. So yeah, I could soon go down there, clean it up. Think the freewheel has gone. I think that's what's wrong. I think the teeth on the gears look a bit worn. Especially sixth gear, so if my suspicion is correct, that's going to be the issue. So I'll change that. But as far as I can tell, the brakes work, the gears work. Just needs a clean. Handlebars tidied up a little bit, and I can chuck that up. That's something I could do tomorrow. Probably about half an hour's worth of work, and then I could chuck it up for 20 quid. Oh. So, yeah, not a bad day. Definitely a better deal. No, I don't mind sacrificing £10 if I'm going to get a half-decent bike in return as well, as part exchange. But, yeah, he seemed happy with it. He took it for a ride around the front there. Had to loosen the quick release a little bit on the seat because I did it up too tight. He couldn't get it off. I struggled to get it off, actually. Oh, and one other thing I've been doing, just quickly before I decide to get something to eat and shift these wheels. I've got a set of wheels in this. They're holding air so far. I've got those CST MTB traction tires on them, whatever they are. The ones I got a puncture in on the way back from Cat's Custom Trunks. But I've checked them and double checked them. I cannot find anything in either of them tires that may have caused it, so fingers crossed. I'm changing that front derailleur because I've got a nicer one just through the back there. Because that one, even though I've disconnected the gears, it's stuck in top gear. So I don't know if someone's whacked the... Actually, yeah, they have. They've whacked that screw down, but that's rusty there, look. So I'm just going to change it. I've got to split the chain to change it, but that's not a problem. Give that derailleur a huge clean out, because if you look, that's completely caked in shit. Look at that. It's even worse the other side. So that'll get a good old clean out. I've got to take the crank off because I've got to put a brand new bottom bracket on it. Because, it's not going to do it because it's leaning up. I'm going to paint the shoulder of those forks. I'll get some sand. Actually, I've got some sandpaper downstairs. I'll bring that up, sand that all down so I get a nice smooth surface, and then just stick some black paint over it. Get some nice looking dust caps to put on this, because I do like nice dust caps. But these are the wheels that were in my Claude Butler in the lounge. I stuck them in this one. But I've yet to find the difference between this and the giant boulder I had. Oh, I know what the difference was. Or is. My giant boulder didn't have front suspension. Other than that, this would be, it's an identical frame, but the giant boulder I had had solid forks in the front, not suspension. Yeah, I've just remembered. I've got a thing for hard tails like this. I don't like dual suspension bikes. I used to love them, but nowadays, I've actually been riding hard tails since before my orange Gary Fisher got stolen. I've ridden hard tails for quite a few years now, and that's just what I prefer. I don't like full suspension bikes. I've actually decided, even though I wanted one as part of my personal bike collection, unless I can find or come across a very good, decent one, I don't want one. I've certainly got a half-decent personal collection going here, haven't I? Take what I want off those handlebars at some point, and they can go on the trailer for... Well, I was going to say scrap, but they'll just go in the car and go down the dump to the scrap bin. Possibly at the weekend. If I go over to Mum's. I should be going over to Mum's. Right. Nearly 10 minutes of jabbering, but I've been doing a lot, so I've updated you on quite a lot. Yeah. I think that one may have gone down. Nope. Okie dokie. They seem to be alright, so I'm just going to pick one. I'm going to chuck it in there, pump it up, and hope it stays up. I've got room on my landing now. I can actually put a bike out there, and I could bring that BMX up here and get it done. I'm going to go down at some point and put my bike in the shed. That lady's bike, I think I'll have to lock up outside because I haven't got any room. But actually, Cat's Custom Trikes is back online. She did lose her internet, I was correct. That was starting to worry me, that was. I'm going to have to remember to give her my mobile number. I think she's still got my landline, but... I could give her my mobile number, but I barely charged a bloody thing up and use it, so... I sort of think, is there any point? I don't know. Oh well. I'll talk to you all later, because I think Nemo wants some food topped up as well. So, peace out for now. Might have to put my fan on again, people. Ooh. Looks like I could do with a wash. Yep. That's what comes from working with greasy, dirty items. But you can't be scared of a bit of dirt if you want to make a bit of money. Anyway, I've just been outside and I took that lady's bike for a test ride and there's absolutely nothing wrong with it. So I don't know what he was talking about, but... I even dropped it in the sixth gear, which I thought was the dodgy gear, and pedalled as hard as I could. Not one slip. So I've literally just given it a clean. Polished down, cleaned up the wheels. Bit of steel wool over the chrome. Took a photo of it and just put it up online. It's gone straight up for sale. Why not? And my brother has given up with that. Because he's just got a laptop. He got it from our friend Biggles. I've still got a laptop to buy off of him, but that means I'm going to buy that memory. It's going to cost me 50 quid, but I could upgrade my motherboard actually if I really want to. Right. I do like using a little thumbs up thing when I'm chatting to people on Facebook. I don't know why. Ooh. A friend of mine's actually shared my air ambulance post. Because I've got these that was posted. Because I play the East Anglian Air Ambulance Lottery, which is ran by the same people. That's the name of the charity, Magpus Air Ambulance. I've mentioned these before. Well, I thought, why not? Mum wants one, so that's one sold, at least. I think stepdad should buy at least one. As, he's, you know, been on the receiving end of their service. And, probably if not for them, things could be a lot different, so... that's why I support them. I had to cancel it for a little while because money was getting tight, but they phoned me a couple of weeks ago asking if I'd like to come back. You know, they didn't force me to do anything. They just said, you know, we understand people have getting money problems or they change banks and forget about it, which is apparently quite common. And yes, I decided to go back. Now that things are looking a bit better. It's only £4 a month, so it's £1 a week, I think. Something like that. £4.23, £4.25, I think. Because they said the other 25 pence makes up for the extra week in a that you can get in a month, apparently. Something like that, I can't remember now. But it seems like if you support them like that, they'll send you out a little pack like this for their raffle for you to sell their raffle tickets. So people give me the pound. I could collect it all up, put it in my bank, and let them direct debit my account. He's just said, if all goes to plan, touch wood, would I be interested in a monitor? Yes. Just for the simple reason, the last one I had often doesn't have a stand for it yet. And the one he's going to be offering me, so long as this goes to plan, he just said every cloud has a silver lining. Was to show me a video of the laptop he bought. It does power up and powers up to a screen, which means it should go into the BIOS, which means it's promising. As long as everything else is working on it, such as the keyboard. Might take my hard drive out just in case someone decided to take the hard drive off, you know, for data security. Some people do in computers and laptops. Some people don't. Some people just don't give a shit and just throw the laptop away. But some people do. So I'm going to bring that just in case. He said, I'm literally selling loads of stuff to you. Actually, I can remember, it's the RAM, the laptop, he has another laptop that works, it just needs a new keyboard, because not all the keys work, so pick and mix, and a monitor now, so it's three items. Oh yeah, I've got that BMX up here, that back tire looked like it's held air, so I'm going to have fun and games getting that fucking back wheel in there, I tell you that. Well, I'm not actually looking forward to it. But my theory is, it came off as it is, so it should go back on as it is. That's only in theory that... Oh, before I shut the camera down for a little bit. Sitting, securely locked to my trailer, is the girl's bike I got. Can't really see it properly from here, but there it is. Get up here with my super glue. I've got bits falling off my squirrels. Yeah, so this is definitely going to need an oil change. It looks rusty, but it is still flexible. It hasn't seized, which is good. Rear brake hasn't seized. It still operates, so... I thought that was a left-hand drive car for a second. It might even be a left-hand drive car. Oh, look at that. Put the bike up the right way for me to get hold of that and stick it straight in. It does seem to be holding there. I was hoping that fork will go into that gap. Doing that the night nap might even be a bitch to get in there with a spanner, but we'll see. Right. What driver is that? Oh, that's the one that's got to go on my Claude. It's got to go on Claude. Right. Off I go to do a bit more work then. Then a bath, and then I'll be back on camera. Hopefully. And I come back quickly, just to say the BMX is done. See, all back together, the back wheel went on fine, actually. It slid straight on and I managed to get in there with an open-ended wrench and tighten the wheel. The rear brake is sticking a little bit, but needs a bit of grease and all these cables, so I'll sort all that out tomorrow. I've got no... Well, the oil can's not up here, but it does... functioning better than it was. I've managed to free it up by pulling it. So front brake is now working. I had to replace all of this. So it's ready to go. I've just got to take it down, oil the chain up. Bearings are fine. Bearings are fine. Bearings are fine. No playing there either. So yeah, his boy's got his BMX back. Or will have. Like I said, I just want to. Oh yeah, I've got to put the other stunt peg back on and take it downstairs, give that chain a good oil, and yeah, it'll be good to go. If he wants, he's gonna knock a tenner off my bill, because that's what that would have probably cost. Well, it would have probably cost more than that in a cycle shop. You know, £4 for an inner tube. Well, probably £5 for an inner tube in a proper cycle shop. £2 for the cable, inner and outer. Maybe a bit more in a cycle shop. Probably £4. So that's £8 alone. That's without labour added on top. If we say half an hour of labour, so another fiver for labour, you're looking at close to £15 in a cycle shop. But, of course, I don't charge new prices on new parts, because I use used parts. So, I can't, can I? But, yeah, that hadn't taken me that long. About 20 minutes-ish. But I'm still not quite done yet, am I? Because I've still got to roll that chain and put a stunt peg on and just adjust this rear brake. So by the time I factor in that lot as well, yeah, I think a tenner would be a fair price. Oh, my seat cover's coming off again. I keep coming off. I may see about adjusting that and getting that on there properly for him. I don't know why he's got this on, because he wanted me to keep my eyes open for a proper plastic BMX seat. But his son's got this extra soft cover on it. If he doesn't like the seat that's on it, he ain't going to like a proper plastic BMX seat, is he? Oh dear. Kids, eh? I want one thing 1 minute and something else the next. Oh well. It's all in working order now, almost. I'll just drop some oil down the cables. and work it in. That should help it. I can't use WD-40 because I haven't got any. I forgot to get some again. Well, more like I spent the money before I realised I had to go and get some WD-40, so. Anyway, I'm going to turn the camera off because I now want a bath because I'm sweaty, I'm sticky, I'm filthy. Look at my jeans. Right, talk to you in a little while. Well, that feels better. I'm still itching like crazy. I just had a bath, so I've got no pants on, but I've got a shirt on. Someone going past and push by. I go past about this time every night. Coming back from work, maybe. Skate park. It's another possibility. Well, as my brother's decided not to bother with that computer anymore.
Yeah.
Pardon me. I've decided I'm going to use that case. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to stick everything from that case into that one. Also, I've decided I'm going to use that motherboard with the Corsair DDR2 memory in it and the AMD dual core 3 GHz processor. Or 3.33 gigahertz processor. Because I like this board better, if I'm honest. Heatsink will swap straight over from the other PC, or I've got plenty more I could choose from for an AMD socket. But I think with all the other cooling that will be included, I'm not going to need it. I'm just trying to think what headers I'm going to need. So if I use this motherboard, I'll just swap this with what's in the case behind me, put the processor thermal paste and heatsink on this one, and put the other Corsair stick of RAM in it. I think 4 GB might be the max, I can't remember. And just take the hard drive out of that one and the video card and slap them in the one behind me. And I will actually go online to see if there's any drivers for this board as well. It's not that ancient, and it is a good brand, so yeah. That's the plan of action. I could do that tomorrow, I think. I haven't got nothing else planned. Just checking the caps. They look in good condition. I've got 4 SATA ports. SATA 2. 2 USB headers. System fan. SPDIF IO. Even got a floppy disk drive. Yeah, right. I haven't used those on my modern PC builds for ages. Front audio. Oh, there it is. CPU fan. Yay! Fucking itch. There we go. That's the plan. So I've got 2 of these Corsair RAM and 2 of the others. In fact, I could keep that PC as it is. And perhaps sell it as like a project for someone. I'll take my pill this evening. Da, da, da. You know, what highways should be doing, what highways actually do are two different friggin' things. Right. Should we just check and see if I've had any mails regarding my lady's bike? I've actually got three. Jesus. I've only just put the lady's bike up there and I've got someone eager. She sent two emails. So I'm just putting it down so I can reply. One at 9:32 and one at 10:08, a few minutes ago actually. And there's a spaz actually makes a change. And someone is interested in the rally. Spam folder doesn't want to open. Right, I'll just reply to her. Put a little smiley on the end of that one. Spam folder! Spam folder! You open the fucking spam folder! Okay, Yahoo's being a bitch. Won't open my spam folder. I've got a message sitting in there and I can't get to it. Nope. Definitely in my inbox. Because it's highlighted. Right, don't want to delete that one. I don't know, we seem to be stuck in my inbox at the minute. It's not the one I wanted to. I want to delete those two. Fuck it, nothing's working. Bollocks to it is what I say. You can tell this is a newer board because it's got rid of the South Bridge. It's only got the North Bridge. Or is that the South Bridge? It might be the South Bridge. I know they got rid of one of the bridges. Supermarket's brought back my favourite sandwich. Sausage and egg. Not bad for £2 either. Right. We're a lot on this board. We've got serial, VGA, 4 USB 2, Ethernet, audio, PS2. Still got the old printer port. I think these days with motherboards, they could probably do away with that now. And instead of have all of that, they could probably do away with VGA as well and put DVI on it. possibly. And put in its place perhaps some more USB ports, as that's what is popularly used nowadays. You know? This is a nice looking motherboard. could go Intel, but got an AMD powered video card in that with an Intel motherboard, I think. So I figured I might as well just go AMD all the way. I could do it tonight actually, but nothing on my feet. And I'm wearing socks on carpet, so that's a bloody huge static risk. So I'll do it tomorrow when I've got my boots on. Anything I can watch? No. Right. I suppose that is it. Not much to talk about now. My mum wanted the laptop my brother just bought, but he offered her his other one, and she didn't want it. Even though she wanted that in the first place, so. I don't know why, because it'll be a frickin' good laptop when it's done. All it needs is a keyboard. I don't have. I sort of feel bad for Mum, because now my brother's got a decent laptop. My stepdad's got a decent laptop. And she's still using an old Windows XP. And I don't have anything to give her. I've got one of mine that runs a gig and a half of memory. Really needs to be up to 2 gigs. Before I give it away to her, if she wanted to use it. I mean, that works absolutely fine, that'll do her. I don't need it, I just bought it because it was offered. And I got it cheap. Most of my laptops are old. Older than the one she's using, so not really much good. And I want to keep the one I use in at bedtime, so that only leaves my Acer, which I was actually going to keep as a spare in case the one I do use at bedtime does shit the bed. But, nah. I'll talk to her next time I see her. I might see her tomorrow. I don't know. I haven't heard nothing. She may even phone tonight. I don't know. I'm surprised she hasn't yet, actually. What? Oh. Twat. I was just swinging my leg back and forth and the cat come running up. Straight into my foot, so I kicked him straight on the nose, dipstick. Not that you'd actually notice it would affect him now, I mean, look. He's just got his back to me. Wait. Get this BMX finished first tomorrow before I do anything. It is virtually finished, it's just a few adjustments I want to make. Well, the chain's got to be oiled. So if I actually get that sort of done first thing, then that can be soaking till he comes to pick it up. If he comes to pick it up tomorrow, why not? Come get it over the weekend, as long as it's not Sundays, because Sundays is usually my booked day. Anyway, I think I'm going to disappear. I don't think I'll be doing anything for the rest of the night. I'm feeling a little bit peckish, though. But I've been using Flora butter. I've had icky guts ever since I started using Flora again, so I think it could be floor spread are absolutely fine on Violet. Maybe it's not a lactose issue, because I have had a bag of chocolate today as well, a bag of Galaxy buttons. Don't be a dick. Thank you. Don't you think about it, because I ain't got... Oh, you are lucky. Lucky you didn't use your claws, because I've got no trousers on. Say hello to all our viewers. This is my channel, you know, not yours. We could make it your channel. Oh, here we go, his motor's going. I've completely lost a thread in what I was saying before he distracted me. Completely gone. Oh yeah, that was it. Maybe there's certain ingredients in certain spreads that my guts don't like. It's a bit like Mum, actually. She can't use Marge because it doesn't like her. A bit of skin. I don't know. Could be a lactose intolerance to a certain degree. You know, if I have too much, maybe. Because it does, when I was reading up on it, it can vary. I'm gonna go. Normally he doesn't get on my lap unless I've got trousers on. But he's decided to, but he's not using his claws. On second thoughts, I can feel, on one of his paws, I can feel the claws just starting to protrude. Oh, no, he's moved. Yeah, I love you too. You're in my space. Woo! Alright, I'm going to call it a night and get this video up. Thanks a lot for watching. I think Nemo says thank you as well. If you don't watch my videos for me, watch them for him. I'll try and get him on video as much as possible. Is that a deal? Good. Alright. See you later.